Kenya.
And I'm Allegra. So we're here today to ask you, what is racism? The official definition of racism is prejudice or discrimination based on of someone else of a different race based on the belief that your own race is superior. This sometimes gets confused with stereotyping. However, stereotyping is having a perceived notion about a group of people or a certain type of person. Although they do get confused, they do have differences. There's a long history of racism in the United States. However, we're here today to talk to you about the future of racism in our country.
There are 7 billion people in the world. That is a lot of people. They are homogenous. They come from different races and ethnicities that possess different cultures and traditions. For example, the continent of Africa is made up of 54 different diverse countries. And the people of Botswana are vastly different from the people of Ethiopia. Different cultures and traditions possess different things. For example, in the world today, a lot of people have a lot of different cultures that really drive them and that really decide what they want to be. In America, in the United States, we categorize different people based off of various different cultures. And the world is small and large at the same time. The world is small, in which the accessibility to information is unparalleled. If a person has a means, they can travel to a different region of the country, or they can research indigenous culture at their fingertips. But the world is large as it is physically large. The earth is home to all of us. In the United States, we have a variety of different categories that categorize people and decide their treatment in this country. The most prominent way we categorize people in the US is race. Also, socioeconomic status, class, also have, in addition to race, different ways that we categorize people.
So how is racism perpetuated in society? Is it solely based on the color of our skin, or are there other factors that play a part? National Geographic published an article in which they predicted what humans will look like in 50 years. As you can see from these photos, it's very hard to tell what category these people belong to. You can't look at someone's face and say, oh, they're white, or they're Asian. The United States Census Bureau only started taking in statistics of mixed-race people in 2000. In that first year, 6.8 million people identified themselves as being two or more races. And only 10 years later, in 2010, that number jumped up to 9 million people. This shows how fast this growing category is in the United States and how it's affecting the racism in the United States and what it's going to change.
I identify as African American. I come from different multiple identities. My father's Puerto Rican, my paternal grandmother is Native American, I have distant ancestry of French and Irish, so technically I'm just a conglomerate of different races. Today in America, there's about 300 million people. That's a lot of people. And white people or Caucasian people make up the majority, about 63.7%. African Americans follow, which is about 12.2%, and Hispanic or Latino people follow about 16.3%, followed by some other small percentages of Asian, American Indian, Pacific Islander, Alaska Native, etc. At Arcadia, in the population here, is about 4,000 students, and it's pretty reflective of the national demographic. Arcadia, white Caucasian people make up 63.3%, followed by African Americans, who make up about 10.2%, and Native Americans make up about 0.7%. And Hispanic and Latino population make about 8.2%, which is continually reflective of the national demographic.
So this growing diversity causes a lot more people to ask, what are you or where are you from? There are a lot of people that are actually making their own names because it's not so simple to answer this question. For example, if someone is black and Chinese, they might call themselves Blackanese. I have a friend who's Filipino and Latino who calls himself Filipino. My family calls me Cafe con Leche or Coffee and Milk because I am half Latina and half white. So, this growing diversity poses a question to what humans will divide people to in the future. Will it always be based on the color of our skin? In ancient times, in the medieval era, racism actually did not exist. People were divided based on how much money they made, or the language they spoke, or what their religion was. And in Brazil, your race and wealth actually have a lot to do with each other. As you become wealthier, or as you become poorer, the racial category that you are assumed to be can actually change.
So overall, I guess you can say that we have a very pessimistic view of human nature. We believe that society will always figure out a way to divide people, whether it be further division of socioeconomic class or race or entirely new division. Society will always find a way to have the haves and have-nots.
However, the idea that people will always find a way to divide others is just that, it's an idea. Race is a social construct and not a biological. So maybe a world without race will provide Americans with an opportunity. An opportunity to reevaluate how we currently perceive racism, and an opportunity to take this opportunity and think about new ways to accept people for who they are and not always create these divides, whether that person be Black, White, Filipino, or Cafe Comanche. Thank you.